everybody, and welcome back to Heavy Rain. My god, this is a harrowing journey so far. Tuesday, 12:06 a.m. In 2 years, we lost our son, our house, our job. Everything's looking pretty awesome. And by awesome, I mean bleak for our main dude, Ethan Mars, which we are not playing today. We are playing the cop. The older cop. There's two from memory. And this is our big old boy right here.
Lauren Winter.
Lauren Winter.
Ring any bells?
Nope. Can't say it does.
Alright, gonna get 7 victims and still no leads. Wow. Okay, we could interact with something there. My badge.
Oh,
my money.
That Lauren Winter.
Cha-ching.
Third floor, last door on the left at the end of the corridor.
Yeah, that Lauren Winter. The one that's the exact same person, but now that I've given you $5, you seem to remember. I mean, that's the point of a bribe, isn't it? Third door on the left, is that what he said? I wasn't really paying attention, Soz. $5 well spent. I'm just going to go for the... Well, we'll go for the second door on the left. Dude, let me in.
It's $50. I don't kiss and I don't do any weird shit.
Fine by me.
Look at her. She looks like a... Oh, what's her name? Something Sheridan. Oh, I can't remember her name now. I like that picture.
Ooh. Put your money on the table. You got exactly 10 minutes when the alarm rings. It's over, okay?
$50 for 10 minutes work. All G. Put my money on the table, you reckon? Very good. I like your apartment. It's very burlesque. It's classy, though. I really like it. She's a cool girl.
Shit, a cop. Mm-hmm. I should have known. What do you want? A freebie? Is that it?
No? Yes?
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private
Scott
detective.
Scott Shelby.
The families of the victims of the origami killer asked me to investigate the murders. I came here just to ask you some questions about Johnny.
Who's Johnny?
I already told the police all I know and have nothing to add. Leave me alone.
Convince, compassionate, persist. Convince.
The killer is walking around free as we speak. He'll kill again if he's not arrested.
Hey, Johnny's dead, so what difference does it make?
Because you can help prevent more. Compassionate.
I understand.
No, you don't. I don't think that was the best thing to say.
Oh, yeah? You know what it feels like to find your own son's body on a wasteland?
No, I don't.
I'm sorry. I don't believe you have the slightest idea what I'm going through, Mr. Shelby.
If we don't find the killer, there'll be other mothers who find their son's
exactly.
body on a deserted wasteland.
That's not a trick. That's truth.
But you're right. Why should you care? It's not your problem anymore, right?
What do you want to know?
Information. I guess. Disappearance.
How did your son disappear?
He used to go play with the neighborhood kids after school. It was pouring down something awful that day.
It always is. It's called heavy rain.
I'll never forget it. All his friends came home around 5. All except him.
Did Johnny live with you?
Yes. Of course, I made sure he never met any of my clients. I wanted to
Wait, so you were doing this when he was alive?
We needed the money. I was trying to earn enough to get us out of here.
Girl, I thought this is what happened to you after the fact. Oh.
Any leads or witnesses?
No. He said you must have run away and you probably end up coming back.
I guess that didn't happen. How long ago was this?
His body was found 5 days later with an origami figure in his hand and an orchid on his chest.
Oh, girl. I'm sorry. Oh, that's my timer.
Time's up, Mr. Shelby. I hope you got what you wanted.
Don't be hostile.
Get out of here.
I'm trying to help you. Also, you're really pretty, so $50 is such a bargain. You know you could charge, like, at least 4 times that. Hey, listen. Oh, we can't console her. All right. I'll take my leave then. Bye. Well, that was fruitless. Oh my god. That's intense. I'm dying. I've got asthma. Pocket inhaler, right? Oh lord, not in that one. Like I said, whatever pocket I choose, it's gonna be the wrong one. Have a pufferoo on that. Good lad. Ka arm down.
Lauren!
I told you she'd be popular. Lauren, open up, baby. $50 for that? Hell yeah. Bargain.
I already told you, I don't want to see you anymore.
Sorry, Del.
We've got some wine. Because, like, wine, not, right? Eh? Yeah, we're going to go help her. Of course we are. Oh, we're having a fight! We're having a proper, full-on fight right now. Cool. This is a long fight.
I'll see you again, asshole.
Get the fuck out, mate. Yeah, and now Sheridan's gonna be like, my god, my hero.
Better than him, I guess.
Cheers to that.
Who is he?
An ex-client who thinks he owns me. He was getting violent, and I told him I didn't want to see him anymore.
Fair enough. Good girl. Stand your ground.
You should be careful. He'll probably be back.
Yes, he probably will.
Sorry about the mess.
It should be a code word. You should text the code word. Hey, can I come see you tonight?
Thanks.
Say dolphin at the door, and you know who it is.
Oh.
Wait, so every single prostitute that this guy downstairs has as a client in his seedy apartment building... Oh, I'm struggling. He makes $5 a pop every time a customer, like, wants to come see a girl. Yes! This is my man. This is the second detective that I was talking about, and he is the most beautiful person. Look at him. I mean, he looks a lot like Ethan, but in a way hotter way. Okay, so we're turning up for work. 8 o'clock in the morning. Oh, I'm shaking. I'm struggling with something. Lyrium. It's always that lyrium. Let's get that pretty face wet.
Yes, Jill. A body was found here on this patch of wasteland early this morning.
Hello, boys and girls.
It's sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
I'm not a
Agent
sir.
Norman
I'm an
Jayden,
officer.
FBI.
Norman Jayden.
You got a badge or something, Mr. Jayden?
I sure do.
Yeah.
Ready for the quick time. It's not a quick time. What is it? Badge.
You can pass.
Of course I can. I'm a freaking detective. Give me some information.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere.
Beautiful.
Thanks.
So much helpful. Thank you. And here we go. Authorized. This is the face of an authorized man. Onto the crime scene we go. Oh, that's right. We've got these trippy AF glasses and glove combo.
Video memo recording, Agent 47023, Norman Jayden, Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. Time is 8:14 a.m.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Carter Blake.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Oh, he's the
Thanks.
One without the uniform on, of course he is. He's TC for uniform, right? Oh, I can't change the camera angle. Oh, I found me an evidence! Buddy, Detective 101.
Some orchid pollen. The concentration of pollen in the air is quickly decreasing because of the rain, but it gets higher in the direction of the body.
A cat?
Dead cat. The FBI doesn't keep files on dead cats. Not yet.
Oh, that's morbid. Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? We've got so much to do now.
Airy comment. Sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland.
You there!
Hey!
What are you
I'm
doing?
Looking at the body! I'm a detective! Look at me. Oh my god, I'm so attractive.
Lieutenant Blake? I'm Agent Norman Jayden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning, they told me to be here. Now if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place.
I should talk to him first.
Mike, will you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself think here.
Right away, Lieutenant!
So, what happened?
Some guy taking his dog for a piss found a body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much
Charles
more again. Right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the origami killer. Chances are he was drowned, like the others.
Oh, they get drowned. Time?
Has the time of death been established?
Based on the rigor mortis, must be less than 6 hours ago. Sure. We should know more once the coroner has had a look.
Sure.
Tony!
Tony.
I want to see a single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here.
There's
Got
one
it?
Just at the front gates,
yes,
mate.
Lieutenant.
She's hot, though, so it might be all right. Witnesses.
Any witnesses?
None yet. Given the neighborhood, I'd be surprised if anybody saw anything.
Right.
Listen, I'm a little busy here. Why don't we discuss all this
Don't
a little
angry
later
with
back
me.
In the office?
Well, no problem. I understand. Do you mind if I have a look around?
my guest.
I really should have talked to him first.
Hey, Jaden, you come and see me if you find anything, okay?
Sure.
We're on the same team now.
Okay, your little does not give me a huge amount of confidence. I'm gonna put my glasses back on.
Traces of blood detected on the fence behind the railroad line. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion.
Oh, I have to make my way precariously up the bank. Lucky I am in the peak of physical perfection. I really am. A friggin' hot man. Like, actually. I don't even like white boys. That sounds racist. I just like Asian boys.
There's a good chance that they're the killers.
Tire tracks? Oh, footprints. Alright. Oh, these are the tire tracks. Very good.
Very cunning. Tire tracks on the side of the road behind the railroad line. It may be the killer's car.
Clues. I am gonna find you, Clues. I'm gonna hunt you down. Oh, we haven't actually looked at the body yet. Which is quite exciting. Okay, that one. That clue. Origami.
A small origami figure in the right hand. The victim is Jeremy Bowles, declared missing 5 days ago. Superficial wound on the right thigh. The blood is identical to that on the fence.
Interesting.
His face is covered with mud, like the other victims. I think I've seen all there is to see.
Okay, great. I mean, if that's how you feel about the situation, then let's boost it the F out. Let's go back to Blake. My hair's like in one of those... Okay, so I cut it about 2 or 3 months ago to have like a side fringe, you know, like a sweeping side fringe. And for about 3 weeks, it looked great. Now it's growing out and it looks like a pile of wank stain. Woohoo! I love me some wank stain hair. Let's get out of here. Here, get it? Hey, why not? What do I see? I see a bat.
A bat?
It's Tuesday, 1 o'clock. I see a raven, which is not an option, so we'll go, what's the closest thing to a raven? A fox.
A fox.
Crab. Crab is an option.
A crab.
Very good. Death Reaper. Death.
Death.
Wait, who's the person answering this?
Death.
Is it Jaden? Ethan. Fuck. We're Ethan again. Okay. This reminds me of Until Dawn when they're in the psychiatrist's office. It's Josh.
I have the results of your MRI
scans. I'm gonna lie down.
Everything seems to be normal. There is no physical damage from the accident.
From the car accident 2 years ago?
However, I am worried about your psychological condition.
Sure, me too.
I know it's not easy, but you've got to start.
I know I do.
You're not responsible for what happened.
It's like someone on a diet being like, I know I have to be on
it's
a diet.
It's my fault Jason is dead.
It's not.
You can't blame yourself forever for your son's death.
This guy's creepy AF. I'm getting the fuck up.
How is Sean?
He is distant, unhappy. He's unhappy. He is.
I know he's really unhappy. He just can't understand why I seem unable to love him.
And what about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
You should love your remaining kid more.
Sean doesn't need a father like me.
Well, you're the only one he's got. I grew up without a father.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
And I don't mind. I don't mind not having a father. Oh, I've had blackouts. I've had blackouts. Let's tell
I sometimes
him
have these.
He's creepy, but
blackouts?
We're paying him.
Times when I don't know what I'm doing. I recover consciousness sometime later. But I'm someplace
else.
He is
judging us so hard.
And I have no idea how I got there.
Getting up. I'm gonna pace.
Do you think this could be related to the accident?
You suffered a massive concussion and were in a coma for 6 months.
6 months?
I really don't know what effect a shock like that can have on the brain.
Still. Equals. We're peers.
That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation.
Until my money runs out.
You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor.
4:10 p.m. Almost 1 inch of rain. Have you got a problem? Are you hungry? Play school. Let's play. We're at a playground, right?
Aren't you going to go play with the other kids?
I don't feel like it.
Come on. Have a seesaw with me. I used to have to sit on one end, and two of my cousins of the same age. It's not like they were younger and like smaller than me. They were the same age as me. They were smaller, obviously, but they were still like my peer group. Two of them took one of me.
Come on, Dad.
I was twice the size of a person. Make you fly? No, your mom will not be happy with that. You like this? This is great, isn't it? Oh, so much fun. I'm having so much fun. It reminds me of the Sims video when they're jumping on the couch and I'm like...
I bet I can push you so fast you won't be able to stay on it.
Great!
Great! Sounds great! I love to be flung off playground equipment. Thanks, Dad. You're the best. Oi! I'm gonna go for it, son. I've been working out. I am on fire. What do you mean faster?
Faster.
I'd like to see you go faster. Whoa! Going as fast as I can.
Whoa! I think my head is spinning.
Good training for astronauts, though.
I'm so dizzy. My head is spinning. You want to be an astronaut? I thought you wanted to be a game developer.
A boomerang? You know how to use it?
No, not really. I can never make it come back.
Boomerangs are hard to use.
Can I give it a try?
Cool. I actually get to like use it. Are you impressed by me, though? Like, I'm impressive, right?
Whoa, you did
it! I did! I did do it!
Do you want to give it a try?
I won't be able to
do it. Come on!
Come on, let's try it together. Now, the main thing is to get the right position at the beginning. Now, you got to throw it straight and
a little
to the right. Wow, that's hitting
water. I didn't know it was so, like, intense to throw a boomerang. Maybe that's why I've never been able to completely, like, successfully throw a boomerang. Well done!
I did it, Dad!
Good job, Sean. See?
I taught him everything.
That wasn't so hard.
That wasn't so hard. Fine, just shit over my achievements. I've been not able to do boomerangs ever. I just can't do them. I'm alright with that. It's never been like up there on my life goal was to be good at boomeranging. It's fine. I'm a Kiwi. I've got like a love-hate relationship with Australia anyway. Leave. Do you want to leave?
Looks like rain's coming.
Ominous.
I think we better go.
You know, sometimes I remember before. I mean, when Jason was still here.
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean.
Sometimes I wish everything could just be the way it was before.
What do you mean sometimes? Why don't
Me
you
too,
wish
Sean.
Always that your brother
Me
was
too.
Still alive? Come on, buddy. Where are you? What are you doing? You're going the opposite direction of me. I am about to leave. This is the leaving zone right here.
Hey, Dad, can I have a ride on the carousel? Can I?
Sure. Go pick a horse and get on. I'll get a ticket.
What horse are you going to go for? Oh, Mildred. She'll take care of you. You just say, Ethan sent me, Mildred.
Please.
You know what to do. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. What are you looking at? Oh, my God, I'm freaking out again. It's scary. I'm okay now. Oh, I'm at Carnaby Corner West or wherever the fuck it is. I'm on my home street. I got this. Sean!
No!
Oh, I'm a little more eager this time. No! That's good. I'm into it. I'm really feeling the need to find my son this time. I have a theory. When I was editing, I came up with a theory. And, I can't say it yet. I can't say it yet. Oh, the last time we saw him was by the carousel. Oh my lord, where's my boy? Oh, it reminds me of Cedric and Amos, and he's like, that's my son, that's my boy. To me, that is one of the most horrific and harrowing. Oh, back into my house, very good. Excellent choice. Into the bedroom. Kids tend to like hide under their bed covers, under their bed, something like that. That was, well, I cried when Remus and Tonks died. That's when I, like, physically, when I was reading the books, I wept. Tears. Streams. But Cedric's death was the first, like, major, oh my god. Because he was Hufflepuff's champion, you know? Their one shot. I love Hufflepuff. It's my third favorite house. Which maybe seems like I don't love it that much, but I do. My man. My man. And that not so much house is, of course, Gryffindor. Not a fan. Like, I'm not even trying to be edgy and like, oh yeah, my favorite house is totally not like the main house because that's so mainstream. Like, I genuinely do not identify with Gryffindor at all. Okay, I'm hot man at my workplace by the looks of it. All right, I'm into it. Who do you think I'm screwing, if anyone? Put on my glasses for sure, or cross my legs. That's fine too. I can play a game, right, like a Tetris style game. There we go. He just wanted to do that straight off the bat. No questions asked. Investigation, what? Not when I've got Tetris to play. Boom. Oh, we don't knock anything out? What's the point of it then? It's not even a game, it's just throwing a ball. It's sports! Are you a sports boy? Oh, the cop's just like, you okay there, dude? Yeah, totally fine. Look at all my buttons. You know I'm a fancy dude when I've got four buttons for a cuff, surely.
Do you think it's gonna take long?
Oh,
no, he should be finished soon.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Oh, here he comes.
Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is
here.
It's
me. Kia ora. That's me. Hi.
Jaden, of course. We've been expecting you.
I'm really
handsome. I'm in a bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course. I wanted to introduce myself before getting started, but perhaps there's a better time.
No, it's fine.
What are we doing?
You know how to tie a knot in a necktie.
No, I don't.
I guess.
All right. I went to boarding school, and I had to wear a necktie.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI
and a blazer.
On this one, but the press
and I could not tie a tie to save my life. It was not my thing at all.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it, it's none of my business.
Nailed it.
No, of course not. All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator. And we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter.
Very good, sir.
Not bad.
Thank you. All those years in boarding school, eh, buddy? Paying off.
Oh, go see Charlene. She'll show you to your office. Yeah, check in on the press conference if you're interested. It'll give you an idea of the political
climate. Definitely interested.
Here.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to the club, Jaden.
Nice to be here, sir. I'm excited. This is cool. Charlene, my girl, my main lady.
Nice watch.
Oh, it's the present we offer to our new lieutenants. We've bought the same model each year for the past 20 years for each promotion. It optimizes everybody's time, and it's the kind of thing that always goes down well. You can contribute to our fund if you like.
Sure.
We're still a few dollars short.
Sure, I'll do that. Yeah. Okay.
Congratulate Larry on my behalf. Captain Perry said you could show me to my office.
Yes, of course. Follow me.
Right here? Oh, nice. Candy. Not a nice office.
This is my office?
That's where I was told to take you. If you need anything, you know where to find me.
Good location. I mean, you've always got to compromise, don't you? Location, location, location. That's what Kirsty and Phil always say. Are we gonna do some work? Oh, I mean business. Serious business. It does look better there. You're right. Completely right. I would put it probably along the other wall, but glasses on. With this character, first point of call, glasses on.
Step one. Change the office.
Already done that. Beautiful job. Glove action. All right, we've got a leaf. What's your favorite season? I was going to say mine is autumn, but it's very gooey and it's very slippery. Files. Clues. Let's have a look at our clues. We found a lot of them, including a dead cat. The tracks. That seems like a very good place to start. Analyze. Analyze the shit out of that. Tire tracks.
The killer's car is probably a Chevrolet Malibu 83.
Chevrolet Malibu 83. Very good. You're so smart. Orchid. There was a lot of pollen.
That doesn't help much.
Does it not? I thought that would be a good one. It's so cool.
8 victims in the last 3 years. Oh, boys. The victims disappear from public places in broad daylight. No one notices anything. Always the same ritual. An origami in the hand, an orchid on the chest. The victims have always been dead for less than 6 hours when they were found, which means they remained alive for several days before being drowned.
I may or may not have had a nap. I'm back now, though. It was just because the lighting was getting gross. Let's go and look at the press conference. See what's hot on the news junket. Or not. Why are all the characters, like, messed up?
Here we go again. I better go wash my face.
Oh, have we already missed the opportunity to go do that? Press junket thing.
I need to take some. I'm gonna faint if I resist.
I'm gonna faint if I resist. Like Voldemort
right.
Styles.
I know I can make it. I know I can make it.
Take trip. Exit. Just go wash your face. You said that all you have to do is wash your face and you'll be sweet. What happened to that plan? Ask Charlene. Bathroom.
Is everything
Tom,
all right?
Tom, bathroom, please. Are you okay? Walks
no,
away.
Thanks. No one will see.
What am I doing? Go wash your face. Am I just going to stand here like this? Am I, like, hurting myself? It looks like I'm pinching my skin. What the hell was the point of that? Why give me the option? I guess that proves how strong drug addiction is. Did you see that, Charlene? Please don't put that in my permanent record. Just scratch that. It's fine. That's Ethan. Am I Ethan again?
It was this afternoon. I went to the park with my son, Sean. We played together for a while. And then he wanted to go on the carousel. It must have been about...
Oh, I don't remember. Four...
4:45, I think. I'm not really sure.
Must be.
What was your son wearing when he disappeared?
I don't know.
He was wearing a coat.
It was green, wasn't it?
A green coat.
I'm really not sure about anything in my
life.
And
a pair of pants.
The pants were, brown. Right?
I can't remember exactly. It all happened so fast.
You say you took your son to the park after school. Mm-hmm. But you didn't report him missing until 8:15.
Yes.
Why did it take you so long to contact
I
the police?
I tried to look for him myself. I searched.
I searched the whole neighborhood for him. I thought he couldn't have gone far.
All right. That's all the questions I have for now. You're free to
sure
go, Mr. Mars. We'll continue to look for Sean overnight. We'll contact you if we have any more questions.
Oh, hey! You!
Did they find something?
Grace!
No, nothing yet, but they're gonna keep looking through the night.
Do they think it's the origami killer?
Yes.
It's still too early to say. But it is a possibility.
What happened, Ethan? How could you lose Sean like that? You should never have taken your eyes off him. I mean, for God's sake, how hard is it to keep your eye on a child in the park? Why did you leave him, Ethan?
I have
Why?
Blackouts, Grace.
Wasn't it enough losing Jason?
Oh, don't throw that in my face. Who do you think you are? What's that
Sorry.
Got to do with anything? Yeah.
It's not what I meant to say.
It's what you said, though.
I miss him so much.
Because now's not the time to cry about Jason. We've got a missing son, Grace. These guys really don't love Sean as much as they did do Jason. A serial killer might have their other son. And she's like, I miss the other one so much. It's very upsetting. All right, we might end this part here. And when we get back, we always seem to start with this guy. And by always, I mean once. So if you enjoyed this episode, you know what to do. Like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I shall see you next time for some more Heavy Rain. Janet!